Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and today we are going to learn about the object models used in the PowerShell that will comes with the properties and the methods. So we're going to learn how you can use the properties and the methods in the PowerShell. Here is the unit covered in this module, the object models. So object model, what is an object model? Object model is the structured data and combine similar information and capabilities into the entity, a collection of part of how to use them. Now, object-based cell, everything is represented as an object in the PowerShell. Object that have the fields, that's called property, and the procedure, that's called the methods. And the properties and method are collectively known as a members. An object is an instance of a type. A type represents a constructed and the define the template of the members. Now identify the properties and the methods for an object. So how you can identify the property or the method for any of the object. So get member. Get member displays properties and the method. Methods are action that can be taken, and typically it used in the pipeline. So when you want to use the get member, you have to use the pipeline, and the get member will provide you the properties and the method V how to use with your data. What is object, what object type I'm using? So get members only shows the type name. An object can be passed or piped into the get member to retrieve the type information in additional to the member list. In the pipe, member type of object thrown will be used as input, might differ from the root object. So let's take an example how we can use the get member. So here is the example: get service pipeline get member hyphen member type is a property. Let me open my PowerShell and I can show you how you can do the practical. So type here get hyphen service pipeline get member and let's put the enter. So here is all the members type we have here, that is alias property, events, method and the property. So both the things, all the things are listed down here related to your get services. Let's understand first for your what is this. This is a member type. So type here your member type hyphen is the method. Take the first property actually. So let's go for the properties, and what we can use with this service object or the service data or with that output, what are the property we can use? Property that means is you are getting the information, you are pulling the data from this services. Let's write the command get hyphen service and filter the data for bit service and enter. So now here is bit service is showing stopped bits and this is the display name. And property, what how to use the property in this? Let's go with this and just in a make it in a bracket. Okay, let's go here and type dot and any of all these property you can use, so you will get the output for this. It will give you the property of this services. So bits property is here, output is a stop bits and the display name, and I'm going to check the status. I'm going to use the property called status and enter. So now directly you get the status that is in a stop mode. Let's use the other property status dot startup type and enter is a manual. Or any of service you can any of property you can use by the service type service name. Let's go with the service name. Service name is the bits. So that's how you can use the property for any of data. You have the command, and what are the properties you can use? Get the property with this command, and you can utilize your the property. Let's try with the other method. Let's use the methods. So here is the bits, and go for pipeline get hyphen member, and now here is a member type, and what I'm going to use it, let's remove and type the method, me method. And what type of method we can use? Method is the action. Method means is you can take a action on your the output, or the get service on the top of that you want to take any action. So property is will give you the value outcome from the service. You can read the value, but method is used to take a action. What are the action we can use? You can stop, you can start, you can refresh, you can pause. So let's write this command, get service, get hyphen service, hyphen name, and it's a bits. And first let's check the status for this, and based on that, we'll write a command to take a action. Dollar status. So this service is in a stop mode. Now we're going to take a action. We're going to use the method to start the service. So go here, remove this, and use the start and enter this start. Okay, sorry. So after that start, you need to bracket start and the close. So here it's clearly mentioned start, avoid this. Okay, so use the start and enter this. And now the service is started. Let's check the status. So now the service output is showing as a running, and earlier when we checked before using the start, it was in a stop mode. Or you can use the any other method also, that is like a stop. So use the stop, enter. Oops. Oh. Stop. So now service got a stop. Let's check the status, and now service is showing in a stop mode. So that's how you can use the property and the method on your any of PowerShell command, and that will you can use the get member to get the member types, like a method or the property. What are the commands you can use, or what are the things are available to use inside that command. Let me go to the next slide. So here we clearly understand get service, get members, how we can use that. What object I'm using? Let's understand get type. Here is we are understanding the what type of data we are using. Get type will provide you the data type. All object have a get type. Method type return returns the type. Get type also return detailed type information. The return value is itself. And the object representing the type, it has a full name property. And here is the example what we can get. So let's see the get type. Let me clear this. And what we have here, the example has given for take any data, like here inside we have something, say blank or data. Type. Why it is not available? Get type. Sorry. Let's say get type. Get, and the type, and bracket close, enter. What type of data is this? This is a blank, but it's also having a some type of data. It's a string. And if you want to check the full name, type the full name and enter. So full name is system dot string. Let's use the other data. What type of other data we can use? Let's define a variable dollar a equal to, I'm assigning like a 5 value, and let's see what type of this data we have. Dollar a, enter, We are output is a 5. Let's check the data type dollar a dot that is a get type bracket close enter. So this data is a is a int type int int 32. Let's take a full name for this, type the full name and enter. So full name is system dot int int 32. Let's take another example dollar b. I am saving a value 10.5 and what type of data it is. Let's try with the dollar b and it's giving output is a 10.6. Let's understand about this data type dollar b dot, it's a get type bracket close and enter. So it's a data type is double. Let's take a full name. Full name is system dot double. So that's how you can use it. Let me give you the another example for the practice. Dollar c equal to dollar c equal to defining the get date enter and dollar c equal, it will provide you the today's date. So what type of this data is stored inside the dollar c? So dollar c dot data type, data type, oh sorry, get type, get get, why it is not giving, let me go here, dollar c dot get type bracket close and enter. So this data type under the c dollar, it's having the format of data is a date and time. Let's get the full name enter. So this is a system dot data type stored in the c dollar. So c dollar containing a data type of dot date and time. Let's try the another example dollar d equal to, let's store the value, it's called abc and store. Let's see the dollar d equal to what it said abc. So what type of this data is, let's check dollar d dot data type data get type, sorry, get type bracket close and enter. So this is a dollar b is containing the string. So inside the data type is a string. Let's get the full name for this. So that's how you can identify what type of data you stored in your variable or in the command, or what type of data you are using in your the PowerShell. Let's go back to the slide now. Here is understanding the get member definition, the property. So here we take an example, get item c dollar host etc get member hyphen name is the last modify date and time. So you can get here is the, this property is a date and time type, and this property can get or the set, we can get or the set, what type of the definition of that. And here is, you can use define this all value you can saved into a variable dollar file equal to get item and this is the host file, and the dollar file dot last write name equal to the get date and the get item is this host is the directory for this. If you want to use that command, you can write it down and can use it. I showed you how to get the data type, so you can use that. Now understanding the get member definition, here is example get item from the c colon windows notepad exe and the get member name copy 2. If we are using that command, the get copy 2, and this is giving you to the definition. So data type system io file info copy 2 string destination file name, and the system io file info copy 2 string destination file name and boolean overwrite. What we call this, this is a two parameter set, and this value is called, this method return a system io file info which is a newly copied file. So if you copy this file, dollar file, get file on this, and the file dot copy to on this destination true, and then you can understand the example what I'm giving. So after the reaching there, that's the data type will change. Now identify the type of an object. Type of object type written by the get commandlet. So get date, get member. Let's understand this example here. Get hyphen date and the get hyphen member. And what the output we are getting, what we can use with the get date command. So in the methods method, as you know, for the method we can change anything, that action method in the sense is you can take a action. So you can add or add days, add hours, and add millisecond, add minute, add all these things. And what are the property we can get? The date hyphen date, day, day of the week, and day of the year, hour, kind, millisecond, minute, or month. Let's give a try with this get date, and we are going to use the property dot, let's check year and enter. We are in which year? We are in a 2024 year. Let's check the time of day. Time of day. So time of day, day is 0, hour is 15, minute is 2, second is 21 seconds. So it will give you the complete information about what is the day of time. Any other thing, property you would like to check, you can use date and the month, M-O-N-T-H month. So which month? We are in the 9 month. So all these are said like a property which you can use to get the output. All these methods are actionable. You can take a action on the get date command. So that's how you can use the get date with the get member. Let's move it to the next. Object type written by the get date and commandlet. Get date dot get get type. What type of this data? This is a date, date time data, and get type is the method. Retrieve the type name and available on the objects. Now here is thank you. So thank you guys for watching this video. See you soon in my the next video. I hope you understand how to check the data and how to get the data types.